Hi everyone, in this video I want to share with you my beautiful heartleaf philodendron or philodendron Brazil. It is also called sweetheart plant. Let me get closer and show you how it looks like. Alright, now in my opinion this is one of the best evergreen indoor plant which is easy to grow and maintain. This plant can grow really long. I've seen it growing as long as 4 meter long. Okay, now this plant, because of its ability to grow long, alright, it can either be supported as climber, because this is also a climbing plant, alright, or you can actually leave it trailing from a hanging basket or shelf. Okay, I like to plant it in a pot and leave it trailing like this, as you can see here, because I just love this way. Alright, now this plant has a beautiful heart shaped leaf, as you can see here, with light green when it's growing, when it's still young. Eventually when the leaf gets older, okay, the edge of the leaf becomes dark green with a variegation of a light green and yellowish light green in the middle like this, okay, as you can see here in the video here. Right now this plant filters airborne toxins like formaldehyde, benzene or trichloroethylene. All right this is one of the best feature of this plant. Okay, this is also considered as a air purifying plant. All right so if you're looking for one air purifying plant, this will be a very good plant to have at home. Okay, now this plant is very easy to grow. Okay, you can just grow this plant, you can just grow this plant from cutting the stems. Right, let me show you how this is done. Okay, you can see these stems here with roots here. Okay, you can just cut the stems at the node here together with the root, alright, and then you can either place it directly into a pot with a cocoa peat, or you can also place it in a water to encourage the roots to grow longer. Once the roots start to grow longer, you can transfer it into a larger pot. Let me show you a sample that I've prepared to show you. See this small pot. Okay, I've cut a stem from the plant, okay, and I placed it into a cocoa peat like this. So this is one of the easiest way you can do. Okay, just cut the stem and put it into a cocoa peat like this, and you leave it for 2 weeks, all right to encourage the leaf to the root to grow longer. After that you can actually transfer it to a larger pot. There's another way you can do it also, which is actually cutting the stems and leaving it into a container with a water like this. Okay, this I'm using a bottle just to show you as a sample, alright, but you can use any type of container that you want, alright, and you just leave it for 2 weeks for the for the roots to grow longer. After that, just like the one that you planted in cocoa peat, okay, you just put it in a larger pot. Okay, by the way, when you are transferring it to a bigger pot, use well-draining soil mixed with cocoa peat and perlite. Okay, yeah, because this plant requires a well-draining soil. Okay, let me show you again closely. Now one more thing I want to share with you is that, okay, I keep this plant both indoor and outdoor. My experience shows that this plant really grows well in a bright area without direct sunlight. If you put this plant in direct sunlight, it actually burns the leaf. Okay, the leaves get sunburned, so it's not good to leave this plant in a direct sunlight. Okay, make sure you keep it in a shade area with sufficient brightness, all right with indirect sunlight. Okay, now as for watering, for the plants that I'm keeping indoor, I only water it once a week. Okay, whenever I see the soil is dry. But for the plants that I keep outdoor, I water them every day, because I'm living in a tropical country and it's very hot here. I need to water it every day to keep the plant fresh, alright? So that works for me. Okay, now I also found that, okay, if I leave the soil soggy, okay, and damp, the root tend to rotten fast and the plant die off. So make sure, okay, when you're watering this plant, don't leave the soil become soggy and damp. Okay, make sure it is moist, okay, but not soggy. Okay, because it actually makes the root become rotten. Okay, so that's another thing I also want to share. Now, if when you're watering this plant, right, make sure you don't overwater this plant, because when you overwater this plant, okay, as the root start to get rotten, the leaf will start to turn yellow and the plant will die off, okay. This happens when you are underwatering the plant also, okay. When you are underwatering, the plant also will not get enough of water and will start to die off, okay. Now, another thing that I want to share is also, please do not use any chemical fertilizer on this plant, okay, because chemical fertilizer is too hot, okay, too heaty. It also kills this plant, okay. You can use an organic fertilizer if you want to, okay. Now for me, I use a homemade compost, okay. I use discarded vegetables as well as fruit peels, okay, to make a compost, and then I just leave it on the soil of on the pot, okay, once a month, okay. That helps this plant as well. So you can try that. If not, you can use, as I mentioned, organic fertilizer once a month, okay. Now, after some time of potting this plant, right, you will find that the root of the plant, okay, will grow longer, okay, and even will form something like a tight ball inside the pot, okay. It will be very compact and form like something like a tight ball. So that means it is actually time to repot the plant, okay. My experience shows that, okay, when you are repotting, after you repot the plant, right, the plant also will start to grow slowly, but don't worry, okay, after a few months it will start to, the stems and the leaf will start to grow back normal, okay, grow longer and big, the leaves will grow bigger as normal, okay. So the slowdown is normal, okay, is expected when you repot the plants, okay. So that's one thing you want to take note also. And also, this plant is not edible, okay. So it's known to be poisonous, so keep it away from young kids, all right, as well as your pets, okay. Don't let the pets to chew this, because it might be dangerous, or you know, for life of these pets or kids, all right. So that's what you need to take note, okay. Let's see, so let me think if there's anything else I want to share with you. So far, I've shared everything that I know about this plant. So you see, that's not much about this plant. It's very easy to take care and maintain, right? Okay. So I hope my experience that I've shared with you helps you in growing this plant, okay? And if you guys have anything to share, please also share in the comment box, okay? I also want to learn from you, alright? So I guess that's all for now, guys, alright? Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day and please stay safe. Bye.